Shomerech v'malech v'sicha. I don't hear you. Shomerech. Thank you, second grade. Tiddy na na. Tiddy na na na. Shabbos Kodesh. Let's go back to the beginning again. Yismecha b'malcha. Everybody! I don't hear you! Shomerei Shabbos v'korei. V'korei Yonek. Yismecha b'malcha. Yismecha b'malcha z'cha. Third grade! Shomerei Shabbos v'korei. Everybody, did it I? Did it I? Did it I? You're not coming yet now. Shabbos Kodesh, did it I? Did it I? Did it I? Did it I? Shabbos, let's do one more time from the love part. Everybody help me out. Yismecha. Nice job, kindergarten. Shomer. Fifth grade, help me out. Nice. Yismecha ben malchus ha. Yismecha ben malchus ha. Shomer e Shabbos v'korei. What? It's a regular oneg?
I'll see.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us for today's special program. There are seats available for guests in the front center, if you'd like, or around the rest of the room if they're available.
Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one.
Oneg introduction exercise. Everybody knows their right and their left. We're going to do a little bit of right, a little bit of left, some kicking, and some twisting. Here we go.
Yourself, now walking by yourself. Do your dance, do your dance, do your dance, do your dance.
walk it by yourself. I'll walk it by yourself.
Nice job. Please quietly and respectfully stand and face the American flag. Please turn and face the Israeli flag. Please remain standing and join me for a special tefillah for our brothers and sisters in Israel and all around the world. Thank you. be seated.
This week's Parsha, we will read Parsha Vayetze. In the Parsha, we find that Yaakov married Rachel and Leah. Leah felt that she was not liked by Yaakov, and for this reason, Hashem blessed her and she gave birth to a child. Over the next few years, she had more children. Her servant had children, and Rachel's servant had children, but Rachel was left with no children. Finally, after many years, Rachel was blessed with a child, and she named him Yosef. What an interesting choice of names. The root of the word Yosef is the word Asaf, which means to gather or to add on. What was Yosef being added to? After all, this was her first and only child. In truth, Rachel treated all other children in an equal and loving manner as though they were her own children. We can see from here how important it is. Instead of allowing jealousy to make us feel upset at others, we should treat all others lovingly and with respect. Just as great is the action of Leah, for Leah, having children, was the one thing that made her greater than her sister. And in spite of that, she allowed her sister to treat these children, her children, like they were her sister's children. This takes enormous greatness as well. From these two acts, greatness and kindness, we can learn how much we need to care for others and about others' feelings. Hashtag Kislev is for kindness is not just a hashtag, but a reminder of how we should act at home, in school, and all the time. Hashtag Kislev is for kindness and Shabbat Shalom.
Thank you so much, Eve, for that beautiful Devar Torah. My name is Sarah Antine. I am the director of the Deborah Lerner Gross Jewish Cultural Arts Center. Today, I'd like to thank all the parents for coming. Today, we have a very special guest. We've had a six-week residency with Steve Seifer's Adventures in Rhythm through the Young Audiences. We received a Maryland State Arts Council grant to bring music to our school, and we have fourth, fifth grade bucket drummers coming to perform. So without further ado, I would like us to give a warm welcome to Steve Seifer's Adventures in Rhythm.
That's the talking drum from Africa, okay? One of the first drums ever made, okay? So I came here about 6 weeks ago, and I'm a percussionist, so I play not only the drum set, but I also play anything. Here's how to remember what percussion is. Anything you can hit with your hand, a stick. This is a mallet because it has a big marshmallowy soft top. A stick, your hand, you can shake, rattle, scrape, or even hit against the ground could be a percussion instrument, right? Okay, so we learned all kinds of different percussion instruments like the talking drum, the log drum. These are some of the first instruments ever made, all the way up to the most modern, the drum set, where we took all these other instruments from around the world, the jazz musicians here in America, down in New Orleans. We talked about all this. We learned a little geography and history along the way, some physics about drumming and sound waves, things like that. But most importantly, we learned how to perform. So are we ready to see our first performance? All right. Okay, because I could go on forever. I like to talk, you know. You'll probably find that out by the end of today. Now, this first act we have today, I would like to announce, the name of the band is the Rock Gods. Come on, Rock Gods, come on up here. Each band, so I want to tell you how we came up with these names of these bands. Looks like they've got some fans out there. So what we did was we took a vote a Democratic vote in each class to figure out the name. Because we also talked about a lot of values, what it takes to be in a good band, which just happened to be some of the values it takes to be a good person, a good civilian, a good member of society. Things like respect, compromise. We had to compromise because not everybody wanted the name. But then, if someone gives a little, then we can all reach an agreement. Is that right? So, we came up with the Rock Gods, and today we're going to sing Bob Marley's Three Little Birds. Is the class ready?
Yeah.
I mean, is the band ready?
Yeah.
Is the band, are the musicians all sitting up straight and in the ready position with their sticks? Aha. Okay, did we have a leader that's going to help sing this one?
No.
No? Okay. Now, before we do the song, let's just do a quick little call and response. What do you say? Are you game? You all want to see it?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Now, call and response means what? I do, then you do, right? Okay, let's go. So we're going to show you our drumming prowess now. Okay, let's give them a round of applause. All right, the Rock Gods. Now you can see why they have their name, you see. Are we ready? Now I'm going to move aside so everybody can see really good, because these guys, this band knows this song so well that I'm just going to sit off the side and let you guys do the show. Are you ready? Bob Marley's Three Little Birds. Okay. Don't worry. Okay? One, two, ready, go. Don't worry. Very good. Wonderful job. Place your sticks on your drum. Stand up, everybody, and let's take a bow like this. Beautiful. Excellent performers, and we just might have some future musicians on our hands and performers. Okay, excellent. Well done. We can all exit the stage this way, and I'd like to easy, nice and easy, and be safe. Careful for the chords. Yep. And I'd like to call the next group. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm round of applause for Berman Hebrew Academies, Bucket Beasts. Yeah. Let's bring them up, the Bucket Beasts. Okay, here comes this wild and crazy bunch.
All right, while they're getting in places, we have a Hanukkah challenge to announce. I'm up here with my friend Svi.
Everyone loves Oneg, right? And the best part of it is chapt. So since we didn't do it since last year, and everyone loved it last year, we're gonna bring it back again.
You know, Mrs. Israel, how do we know you're not, you know, videoing your chopped sessions 3-4 times until you get it right? Rabbi Pepper, how do we know you're not, you know, with your master abilities in technology, just cutting some master chef's footage and slipping it in as yourself? We think this needs to be live. What do you guys think?
Go.
Rabbi Pepper and Mrs. Israel, you're being challenged to a live laka chapt.
Oy vey.
All right. Excellent. So, now we have the Bucket Beast. Now, here's something special about the Bucket Beast. We have our own theme song, don't we? Okay? Okay. You want to do that first? Okay. We're going to do it first. The Bucket Beast theme song. Okay, let me get out of the way for this. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bucket Beast and the Bucket Beast theme song. Are you ready? Are you musicians ready to say yes? Okay, 1, 2, 3, go! We are the Bucket Beast!
We are the Bucket Beast!
Go ahead.
We are the Bucket Beast!
One more time, okay, let's go. We are the Bucket Beast! We are the Bucket Beast! We are the Bucket Beast! Ready? We're gonna go. We band that can't be beat. We're the band that can't be beat. Very good. Okay, very good. We just learned that today. So that was a little, it was bold to start on that one first. Very bold. Now, one song we do know much better is a song by the Godfather of the Soul, Mr. James Brown. Everybody give a big round of applause. Let's just pay respect to James Brown right now. Everybody say, James Brown.
James Brown.
James Brown.
James Brown.
James Brown.
James Brown. James Brown.
All right, are you ready, class? Okay, let's show them now. Okay, when we start off with the famous James Brown scream, are we ready? Stick everybody in the ready position. 1, 2, ready, go.
Wow! I
Well done, well done, everybody. Okay, put your sticks on your drum. Please stand up and walk this way carefully and in a straight line and be careful and walk slowly and we'll have the next group come up. And the next group is, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for Peace Out. We another band might have to do it, okay? Because we had the theme song. Okay. Come on up. It's time for Peace Out.
What is coding? Coding are instructions given by humans two computers in order to make them function. But coding could be used in a lot more things than just computers, including your microwave oven. Anybody have one of these at home? A microwave oven needs coding by a human coder to let the microwave know what we expect it to do. Anything from setting the numbers up to run for a certain amount of minutes to cook some popcorn, or to turn on a light, or to even rotate the tray inside. A human programmer has used coding to set that up so the microwave oven knows what to do. Think about other items in your home that might need coding to be able to function. How about your printer? Or anybody's parent drinks coffee? Anybody have a Keurig at home? Keurigs are also set up by a human programmer to be able to understand when you push those buttons, what you want the Keurig to do for you. Now, when we talk about coding that we're going to be doing during Hour of Code on Monday, some of those coding activities that we're going to do are going to be already pre-created, and we're going to be putting those activities together. And if you are able to, once you pay attention to those steps, you could create your own coding. See you at Hour of Code on Monday. Looking forward.
I was trying to remind you that I remembered your name. All right. Oh, my mic's on. Are we ready now? For this class, we have Judah up here, and Judah did such a great job that we said, hey, why don't you lead the band? And he said, I sure will. So not only is he good, he is not afraid to get up and perform, which is a very special talent. So not everybody. Some people are a little too afraid. And you know what? If you're too afraid, with some practice, anybody can do it, right? Just some people are more naturally able to get up in front of people. And let me remind you that I still get nervous. Lady Gaga still gets nervous. Everybody gets nervous. It's just how you deal with it, okay? We call that stage fright, okay? But most of you guys look like you're ready. You're proud. You're sitting up straight. You're in the ready position, okay? And Judah was going to lead the song. This band is going to do All Together Now by the Beatles, okay? One of my favorite bands. A band that spoke a lot about love and peace, which are not bad things, are they? Right? Okay. Judas, are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay. One, two. Okay. I'm going to hand it over to Judas. And it's all you guys. Let's have it. One. Okay, good.
One, two, three, four.
Yeah!
Excellent job, Judah. Okay, now let's all stand up. Oh, wait. Yes, let's stand up. Let's check our time real quick. They really want to do this song, and I just can't help but let them. You ready? You want to do Che Che Kule? Okay, all the groups got to do Che 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 Kule, and because of time, not everyone got to do it today, and to keep things different. But we're going to let this group go ahead and do Che Che Kule. It's an African chant that I like to teach them in honor of our African ancestors that came up with some of the very first percussion instruments. That all other percussion instruments kind of changed and or evolved from, right? So let's go ahead and sit back down, because we're doing okay on time. And you know what, Judas? Or Judah, should I... You want to do this one again? Okay. He's bold. He's proud. He's not afraid. Let's do it. Okay, so this one. Now, we learned about elements of music. Pitch means what? Tempo means what?
Fast.
How about duration? Long or short, right? Okay. Now, let's do this one. And we learned a lot. We learned about notes too, right? A quarter notes, just like there's four quarters in a dollar, there's four. One, two, three, four. Let me hear you count the quarter notes. All right, sticks up. And who can tell me, one person, raise their hand, how to count eighth notes? Right here. Yes.
One and two and three.
What would that sound like on the drum?
One and two.
And three and four. And one and two and three and four. And six up.
And I know how to do 16.
You do? Okay. How do you do them?
One E and A, two E and A, three E and A, four E and
A. Yes, he does know how to. He's not kidding. He knows those 16th notes. So, one E and a, two E and a, that's a 16th note. So we learned a lot for such a young age. In fact, this might prep you when and if you decide to pick up an instrument. With no further ado, let's run through a quick Che-Che Kool-Aid. Judah, let's knock it out of the park. You ready? One, two, ready, go.
Che-Che Kool-Aid.
Okay, now, since we have just a little time, real quick. Now, we're going to pick up the tempo, faster tempo, higher pitch, which we go from our quarter notes to our eighth notes. So we're going to start out like, I'll help you start out. How's that? One, two, ready, go. Che-che Kool-Aid.
Che-che.
You got it. Adende. Sticks down, please. Awesome. Aren't they a wonderful group? Wonderful group. Judah, let me shake your hand, sir. Wonderful, wonderful. Okay, everyone stand up. Let's take a bow, please. All right, okay. Excellent. Please file to the left of the stage. Just calmly, quietly, do not run, sir.
Hit that once.
What's that?
Can I hit that?
Okay. Okay, we're down to one more, ladies and gentlemen.
Two more.
I tell you, I'm having so much fun, I hate to end the show. Oh, is it two? Yeah, it is two more. Okay, we're doing good. The next up is the Pop Rock Penguins, ladies and gentlemen. The Pop Rock Penguins.
Everybody loves fun shops. Fourth and fifth grade, you have the opportunity to join a special tour game fun shop next week.
Be there. Tuesday, December 10th, Media Center, 11:30 to 12 o'clock.
Be there.
Good job. Okay, now for this particular tune. What's that? Oh, of course, yes. You guys are really on top of it. Okay. This song, guess what? I had to throw another Beatles song in. Sorry. Now, this one is called Yellow Submarine. And for this one, we have Aviva, who's going to help us lead the band, because Aviva really knows this song. And I think the band does too. Are we in the ready position? Sitting up? Sticks in the ready position? Are we ready? Give me a yes.
Yes.
Aviva, are you ready? Give me a yes.
Yes.
All right. Okay. Let's try this. Bum, bum. Okay. On three. One, two, three. Bum, bum. Take it, Aviva. Bum, bum. Where I was born. Come on, everybody. Yes. So we sail. Wonderful. Excellent, Aviva. Wonderful job. Okay, now, we're going to move on to the next band, or do we have anything else planned? I think we need, oh, yes. Okay, let's all stand up, please. Now, that was Alex playing the bell, if you noticed. And that went really well with the old submarine sounds. I think in the actual song they have a bell, I remember. And Alex played it perfectly. Give me a high five. Awesome. Well done. Okay, please exit slowly and calmly that side, and we'll call the last band. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the Rainbow Raiders. Easy now.
We didn't do half and half.
Here's this week's weekly weather update. Today, it's nice in the 50s. Tomorrow will be a little bit chillier, but still mostly sunny. As for Sunday, the same. Then, Monday, with a warmer temperature, comes rain. The clouds will insulate our surroundings, and we will have close to 60, or maybe even on Tuesday, actually 60 degrees. And then the temperatures plummet back into the 30s for Thursday, Friday, and Shabbat, with a little bit of rain on Shabbat, and then, I know you're waiting for it, 21 states have already reported measurable snow. Maryland has had none. There's a chance on Sunday, late in the day, we'll see some flurries of little bits of snow on Sunday next week. But it's really too early to tell, and probably will leave nothing on the ground for us to have a cancellation or delay. Shabbat shalom.
Okay. Now, were you, was that you? Oh, no, 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 okay. All right. Okay, and who else? Okay, for this band, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, we have the last band of the day, the Rainbow Raiders, and we have Noam, who's playing the tambourine, and also
Amitai,
who's also playing the tambourine. Okay, and we also have, I want to tell you that Noam, without even asking, he just, on his own, went and was it 16 different designs he came up with? And he zeroed it down to one, and he's the one who made our Berman logos. So give a round of applause for Noam for going the extra effort without even being asked. What a creative, awesome thing to do. Noam, thank you very much for making a better show. Hey, let's make sure they can see your B. There we go. Okay, and ladies, are you ready? We have Eve and... Oh, wait. What? Say it again?
I yell it.
Well, you have to forgive me because sometimes I learn names for the first time and it takes me a few times to pronounce them exactly right, okay?
I'm used to it by now.
You know what? I am too because I have a funny name too, my last name. So I'm used to it too. My last name, well, I'll tell you later. Okay, ready? So now, here we go. Ayelet and Eve are going to kick it off. Oh, wait. We want to make sure we have a right song. Do we have a right song up? No, we don't. Aha! So this is a kind of a message we want to give for all, from me, from all the classes, from I want to thank Sarah Antine, and I want to thank our principal for having me. Everybody has been so wonderful. The community is just wonderful, and I'd like to come back, and I just might come back and help the pep band. So we'll see. But this song kind of says it all. It's called "Thank You for Letting Me Be Myself Again" by Sly and the Family Stone. Are we ready, girls?
Yeah.
Are we ready, boys? Are we ready, class? Say yes.
Yes.
Okay. Boom, boom, tap. Let's do it. And you guys can sing along. Excellent, excellent. Okay, now, let's put all our sticks on the buckets, please, Navone. And let's stand up. Let's all take a bow. Wonderful job, wonderful job. Okay, now let's calmly, quietly walk. Excellent job, Navone. All right, excellent. Thank you, thank you. Good job, Asa. Careful. Awesome. Thank you all very much.
All right, kids, it's time to finish up, clean up. I want all the scissors back into the scissor lunch boxes. Put your paper clips on, names on your piece. Put your stuff in the 4 Gimmel shelf and all the scraps away. All right, thanks.
Kindergarten. Thank you so much for joining us, Kindergarten. We'll see you next week, Kindergarten.